Now next speaker, Prof. Vishal Sardeshpande.
Good morning. I'll be talking about rural enterprises. So I would try to restrict myself in a given time. I wanted to show you one video of our case study. So let's see how it goes. First, let me introduce you to Sitara. Sitara is Center for Technology Alternatives for Rural Areas. This is an interdisciplinary academic center started in 1985. We have a master level program in technology and development, and we have a PhD program. We study and develop solutions by and large for rural India. Basic themes are soil, water, energy, livelihood, and public health. We have different elements of technology, policy research. So outline of my talk is I'll be, introducing you briefly on rural enterprises. Then we'll be quickly looking at, what are the attributes of rural enterprises? Because everybody talked about, the good part of rural enterprises, but what are the things which are key? And I'll present you a case study with few slides on where we have done an intervention of a solar concentrator in a small laundry. And we look at quickly on key drivers for decision making in rural enterprises, how people make decisions, because I'm working with a lot of rural enterprises and there is a pattern with which they make change. So as far as this rural enterprises go, this by the way, I teach this course in IIT, where we define for our course, this enterprise is owned by local people, employing local people and located in rural areas. You will find there are a number of enterprises which are not owned by local people, but they are located in rural areas. So we are not defining them as a rural enterprises. The crux is that should be owned, employed, and located in rural areas. So it is by and large a subset of MSME, which is registered, unregistered. We are excluding kind of a pure trading activities and basic agriculture and some miscellaneous things like, country liquor. It's owned by local people, employed by local people, but we are not talking about that. So we are talking about enterprises which are rural enterprises which are contributing positively in society. So what are the types of these enterprises? So these enterprises are, they are basically small household units, which are family businesses, which are full-time, part-time, which may be seasonal, okay? And they require low level of skills and low capital level. Micro enterprises, which typically require slightly higher level of skills and it will be kind of, functional maybe for a full year as compared to household. And small scale is more structured and it will be requiring a large capital as compared to both of them. And it engaged in, networking with the other industries. So this is some of the attributes which I have, experienced in rural enterprises. These are basically pitfalls of rural enterprises, where they lack on delegation of responsibilities. Typically, the small businesses, the mentality is, if I don't go to my business, the business will not work. And that actually restricts, the thinking of the business to that person only. Then there is an absence of records. Everything is by and large empirical. Okay. They also do a lot of learning at the cost of business. And there is a lot of thinking in terms of, narrow outlook, inferiority complex, lack of patience, lack of exposure. And one of the things which we found very clearly when we want to, introduce some change in these businesses, they would like to do only familiar activities. They don't want to get into something which is not familiar. So I will be presenting you a quick case study on small laundries. This is typical laundry which is processing around 500 to 800 clothes per day. This is a domestic laundry which is located in a semi-urban kind of area. And you will see different operations, receiving, starch preparation. The starch is, by the way, used for clothes which are whereby politicians they are the major users of this starch based clothes. Then there is a washing, centrifuge, and ironing. So One of the thing what we observed there is a continuous rising cost of fuel, the wood cost which is going up, and it is linked to the cost of diesel or furnace oil. Then some of the things you can see, the storage space and all, and they have abundant use of LPG based steam generators because for ironing, and because this LPG was costly and they were not using steam for ironing, there is an inferior quality of ironing only with the electricity. Then there was no automation, and they can't go for a boiler because the moment they go for a boiler, you need Indian boiler regulation certification. Okay, for small businesses, this is one of the concern where, you know, these products are particularly pressure vessels are available above certain capacity. So this is the solution which what we identified and implemented. This is a solar concentrator which generates steam directly. I have a small video of this which I will run towards the end. So the challenges for implementation, this is interesting to understand because this change was introduced by the owner of the company. But it took huge effort for us to actually adopt this change by the operating team of the laundry. And one of the thing was, there was a change in their existing practices of using the hot water generator which they were using. So there was a huge initial resistance by staff, and slowly we realized that resistance came from the use of PLC. Okay, we have given one PLC in our system, and one of the thing was that PLC needs to be operated by the operator who is a 10th grade pass. Now, while talking to him after 15 days of implementation, we realized that if our person is not there, he is not using this concentrator. And then we realize this is not a familiar environment to him, the using of PLC. So we discussed with him and we changed our PLC similar to the dashboard of a ATM of a bank, which he was familiar to use. And we found that suddenly the adoption of that product went in. So there are such number of things which we tinker around. And let me tell you, after implementation, we did around 250 plus modifications in the product for the adaptability of this. And the other thing I would like to mention over here, this product actually we have developed for a formal market where we would like to introduce this product for steam generation in organized sector. But our first buyer was this small business, which is a kind of a rural enterprise. And there are a few reasons for it, which we'll look at later. Okay. So this was a quick benefit story. Okay. And so one of the thing is quick startup, and this has promoted kind of a resource conservation approach. Okay, so some of these projects which are in pipeline, which where I'm working, time is too short for me to talk about this, but there are variety and there are few more which I have not covered over here. And all these sectors we are actually looking at how to do methodical interventions at various places. So this is the framework which I cover in the course. This is a framework which we utilize to study a small business very quickly. This framework helps you to get onto the two tracks. What we found in general, the small businesses or rural enterprises, they are either struggling or marketing or and innovation, or struggling on the basic operations. And when we do systematic analysis step by step, at this juncture, you will come to know after, you know, the data processing and what to do is very clearly given over here, which path to take and how to do investigation. So this is something which I would like to point out, where this I had inspired from Goldratt, where in order to do any change anywhere, you know, this is a philosophy where making a change, either you should have some treasure, pot of gold, or something which is bothering you, that is alligator is biting you. And there are not making a change, there is a scenario where you would like to take your existing situation to that new change environment, that call it as mermaid theory, or there is a fear of failure. What we found by and large for these small businesses or rural enterprises, only monetary gain is not the point for making the change. Okay. So one of the things what we found with this particular buyer is they also aspire for new technologies or good technologies. And these technologies are having, apart from monetary gains, there are a lot of other interesting impacts on their businesses. And when we want to introduce such changes in small businesses, we need to be open, we need to have more detailed dialogues on how we are impacting on other aspects of their businesses. Like for example, if he has, you know, improved scenario, the labor retention will go up. Because for the labor, you know, doing the same thing, there is no, you know, upgradation of his work. Or, you know, or if you see why he will not make the change, one of the things I told you, the complexity of solution. Or the other thing is dependability on external agency. So, so I'll show you quickly video of the...
जेव्हा माझं लग्न झालं तेव्हा यांना कडक कपडे घालण्याची एक आवड होती. मला थोडस राग यायचा, अहो काय तुम्ही एक स्टार्च केलेले कपडे घालता, मला हे किती काम पडतं. मग ते म्हटले थांब आपण आता याची एक फॅक्टरीच टाकूया, असं म्हणून आमचं एक संभाषण झालं. आणि ॲक्च्युली परभणीमध्ये एवढ्या छोट्या गावामध्ये त्यांनी स्नो व्हाईट ड्राय क्लिनिंग या नावाने इथे लॉन्च केलं.
माझ्या व्यवसायाची सुरुवात मी साधारणपणे 1991 केली आणि आत्ता असं झालं की आमचा जो पहिला बिझनेस होता तो नदीच्या काठावरती जाऊन पहिले जुने लोक मोठी भट्टी लावायचे, त्याच्यामध्ये सोडा टाकायचे आणि मग त्याच्यामध्ये पांढरे कपडे टाकून मग ते सगळं वॉशिंग करायचे. नदी नाले ओढे सगळे आटले गेले आणि मग लोकांची म्हणजे कपडे धुवायला येण्याची संख्याही खूप वाढायला लागली. आणि मग ह्यातून काय झालं की जसं आपण जसं म्हणतो की गरज ही शोधाची जननी आहे, तशी गरज वाटायला लागली की मॅन्युअली काही होत नव्हतं सगळं. आणि मग त्यातला शोध लागला, मग मशिनरी आल्या. मी वर्षा दोन वर्षामध्येच आम्ही एकदम आकाशातला सूर्य त्या पॅनलवरती घेऊन आम्ही आमच्या या सगळ्या धोबी घाटाचं रूपांतर आम्ही या चांगल्या पद्धतीने केलं, असा एक दर्जा मिळून दिला आम्हाला.
This laundry is using this concentrator mainly for ironing and for washing. The steam generated is directly taken at ironing station where ironing is done for different type of clothes. When the ironing is not in operation, steam is used for generating hot water, and this hot water is used for washing application. We have done complete application engineering for this system, where we have studied the requirement of laundry in terms of hot water and steam, and this requirement is customized with the sizing of hot water generation tanks and laundry station.
आज जसं आम्ही पहिल्यांदा लाकडाचं बॉयलर होतं, मग त्याच्यावरती पाणी तापवायचं, मग सकाळी उठला की तो कामगार त्या ठिकाणी ती लाकडं टाकायचा, त्याच्यात रॉकेल टाकायचा. कधी कधी हिवाळ्यात पावसाळ्यात ती लाकडं सरदेलेली असायची आणि ती लाकडं लवकर जळायची नाही, लवकर पेटायची नाही.
पहिला आपण पास काय लाकीड बॉयलर था.
लाकीडचं थोडं प्रॉब्लेम होते, 150 किलो असं लागते. बोलतो तो सिलाने को टाइम लगते, गर्म होने को ले टाइम लगते, ते उसके से दुपट्टा होते, काला कपड़ा पकड़ते, याद से बहुत.
There are two ways to look at the.
नंतर 50% वाढवली, नंतर 75% खर्चा वाढला. माझे फिनिश गुडची किंमत, कारण आपल्याला म्हणजे व्यवसायातनं कमावणं काय आणि व्यवस्थापन लावून त्याच्यामधनं वाचवणं काय, हे दोन्ही सारखंच आहे.
द ईज ऑफ युझिंग दिस मशीन इन लॉन्ड्री, एनीबडी हू कॅन ऑपरेट ATM ऑर स्मार्टफोन्स विल एबल टू ऑपरेट अवर कंट्रोल सिस्टम. वी हॅव गिव्हन सिम्पल स्टार्टिंग अँड स्टॉपिंग प्रोसिजर्स विच आर basically takes 5 to 10 minutes for start and 3 to 5 minutes for stopping the system.
uska solar ka bare mein bole to usko kuch takleef nahi kuch nahi, sabre jaake apna fuel se chalu kar diya, aadha ghanta mein steam aa jata hai, dekhne ka zarurat is nahi sham tak.
The other interesting thing in this
che vachle mi paisani profit madhe alo 25000.
Thank you.